So after you set up your website and your domain, here's a quick snapshot of the back end of my SiteGround account. As you can see here, I have my domain address.com already set up. So after I open this, I'm going to be taken to a dashboard just like this one right here. And the first thing that you want to do is go ahead and install the plugins that you need. So right now, if I head over to the plugins page, we'll see that we have only the basic default plugins that come with SiteGround. But I'm going to go ahead and install my two plugins that I'm going to need for this tutorial. So I'm going to need Elementor. I'm going to type in Elementor. I'm going to install this one, that first one that comes up. And so Elementor is a page builder. It lets us manipulate our web pages and lay them out exactly how we want. And so after activating the plugin, they'll walk you through a few different steps. If you have an Elementor account or if you purchased this plugin, you can go ahead and sign in here, but let's go ahead and just skip it. And now it wants you to install the Hello Theme plugin, which I will go ahead and click continue because I do want to use their theme. Now I'm going to give my site a name. So for this tutorial, I'm actually going to be setting up a wedding photographer's website's booking page. And what she does is she actually goes to weddings and takes photos through Polaroid. This fake business is called Faded Memories. So let's go ahead and click next. And now it's asking me to upload my logo. So let me click open media library. And what I wanna do is I'm gonna actually upload the files. And it's just a emoji. So I'm going to click select. And I think that looks good. So I'm going to click next. And now it's going to ask me if I want to go ahead and use one of their templates or if I just want to start on a blank canvas. So I'm going to go with the blank canvas. Alrighty, so here is my first Elementor page. And just to give you a quick rundown of how the Elementor editor works, here on the left-hand panel, you'll see all the Elementor editor settings. And you'll see that this is the elements panel, and this is going to let you drag and drop different elements, for example, images, text, buttons, icons, etc. Because we're using the free version, we only have access to these basic ones. As you can see down here, these are for the pro version. But you can complete this homepage with just these elements, and it's going to look great. Here at the very bottom, you'll see we have general post settings. So you can name the page, you can set the status of it, apply a featured image, hide the title. In this case, we'll go ahead and do that. And then you can choose the different layouts. So I'm gonna choose canvas just because I would like to just remove that picture that we had at the very top of my logo. I'll go ahead and add the logo later. Going back to those post settings, you'll see that we have a styles panel, and it lets you manipulate the margins, padding, the background. You can also set advanced CSS, but again, this is just a pro feature, so we don't have to mess with this right now. Let's see, we also have a navigator, so if you click on that, you get to see a section by section breakdown of everything on your page, but we can close it for now. You also have the history tab. You can see every single change that you've made, along with any revisions that you've saved. You can also switch into responsive mode, which we'll come back to later because it's really important to switch between the different screen sizes and make sure that all your content still looks good on each device. And then you can also preview your changes, which will open a new tab for you to see what you have so far. Alrighty, so the other thing too, if you click this top left hamburger menu, this is where we're gonna be working right now. This is the general settings, and so you can click the site settings, theme builder, and user preferences from here. We're going to be working with the site settings here in a second because this is going to set our global styles for our website, and we'll get to it here in a bit. So first thing we want to do is I'm going to go ahead and head back to my little widgets area where I can drag and drop my elements. So you just use this little grid button here at the top right corner of the panel. And I'm going to go ahead and start adding a few of my basic elements. And this is going to help me reference what I have set up when I start going through the site settings and all the global styles. So I'm going to go ahead and drop in a few different headings. So here is my first one I just dragged in. And after you drag in an element, you can always use this little pencil button here at the top of the element area. And then that will bring up all the settings for that element. You'll see some pretty standard tabs here. Another thing to help you navigate, it'll also say like what you're highlighting. So it says edit heading. So I know I'm in editing this heading right here. So you'll see the content. Always have a style tab and then the advanced tab. So the content, of course, it's going to let you manipulate what you're actually showing here, as well as a few different things too, like the links, the alignments. Sometimes it depends on what element you're working with. It might be in style or in content. And then the style, of course, lets you change colors, change the fonts, strokes, etc. And then the advanced lets you set stuff like margins, padding, as well as like motion stuff, what the background is, borders, whether you want to show it on mobile, desktop, etc. But let's head back to content. And what I want to first do is I want to make sure I have a few different headings here. So I want to make sure this one is a H1. And just to give you a little bit of background, usually a typical web page is going to have a single H1 heading. And this is going to let Google search engines, or just like search engines in general, give them a good idea what this page is about. And then it starts looking for the H2s, H3s, etc. You want to make sure that you keep that same structure where you always have an H1. You can have as many H2s as you want, and then H3s, etc. But let's go ahead and add in more headings. Another cool thing about Elementor, if you right click on this little pencil tab here for the heading, it'll give you a few more options. For example, you can duplicate it, and instead of having this one in a, since we already have our H1, let's go ahead and make this one an H2. Let's go ahead and just make another one for the H3 heading. And now, instead of making another heading, let's go ahead and add some text. I think that's fine. And then we can also add in a button. I think that's about it. Let's leave it at that. So we have our three headings, we have our text, and we have our button. So I think these are going to be the main elements that I'm going to be working with on my booking page here. So now let's head over to our site settings so that we can set our global styles. Starting from the very top, let's work on our design system settings. So let's click on global colors. And by default, we have these green, gray, and blue colors, but I already have some selected, so I'm going to go ahead and pop them in really quick. Alrighty, so I'm happy with those colors, and I'm going to go ahead and click update. And now let's go back to our general site settings, and let's move on to the fonts. Alright, so now that I have my fonts ready, I'm going to go ahead and click update and head back to my site settings. And next, we'll go through the theme styling. So here, I'm going to click the typography option, and this is where we're going to start seeing some of these styles really take place. So for starting at the very top body, this is going to affect the text blocks like this one. So let's go ahead and set the color to match our text, and then the typography, and we want to make sure it's matching the text we selected. And you can use the little global style button right here to select some of the global settings that we just set. So instead of having to type in the hex code every single time or find the font every single time, the reason we set those global styles in the design system settings is so that we can use these little dropdowns for easier navigation. So let me just go through that really quick. All right, so since I'm only planning to work with the H1 to H3 heading types, so I'm just going to leave the H4, 5, and 6 ones as is. And now that I'm done, I'm going to go ahead and click update. All right, so going back to the site settings, next let's work on the buttons. And for the typography, I think I do want to change the color of this because the red seems a little too stark. So I'm going to change it to white. But now my typography somehow changed, so I'm going to go ahead and change that back to the accent one we had before. Going down a little bit, so I do want to change the color of these. I do want it to be red, like that. And then I can do a few other things here, like the radius. That's going to affect whether it's going to be square or if it's going to be more rounded, like this, more of a pill shape, which I think I'll go ahead and go with the little pill shape for now. You can also set the border. You can set the shadow of these. It's completely up to you. And then you can also set the hover style. So right now, if I hover on this, it's going to stay the same. But I can change that to be something a little different. So let's actually do a little blue hover. If anything, I'll probably go with the darker one. Yeah, I think that looks good. You can also set the padding for the button. So if you need it to be a little more chunkier, you can do that from here. All right, I think that looks pretty good. So let's go ahead and update it. And so this is going to set the default style for all of our buttons on the site. So anytime I add a new one, it'll look just like this. Going on to the images, you can set border radiuses for images and such from here. I'm not going to touch this. I think the images as they are is going to be fine for me. We can also adjust the form fields. Elementor does come with a form element, but I'm not sure if it comes in the... let's double check. Yeah, it's a pro feature, so we won't be able to use it for our free edition anyway. But let's go back to our site settings and continue. Alrighty, so next it's gonna ask us for the header. You get to choose whether you want to include your site logo, tagline, menu. But for this tutorial, since we're just making a single booking page, I'm going to go ahead and ignore this for now. I'm going to build out the header as a part of my page instead of using the Elementor header settings. I think the header and footer come handy once you upgrade to the Pro edition of Elementor. But if you're just building a single page, we can just skip this for now. Alrighty, next we'll go through the site identity settings. And so you can review all the stuff that, some of the stuff that we entered during the setup wizard. For example, the name of the site logo. You can also set the favicon, which is the little icon that comes up when you open a new tab. But I'm just going to go ahead and leave these as is. Next, we can go through the background settings. And I actually do want to set a background. I would like to set it to a nice little, like a vintage yellow. So let me grab that really quick. I didn't add it to my colors, but I'll add it right here. Alrighty, so I have my background color in place. I'll probably just tone it down a little bit. I think that's a little too vibrant. Maybe something more like that is better. All right, and I'm going to click update. You can see you can also add an image or a background specifically for the mobile, for mobile devices. But let's go ahead and go back and go through a few of these last ones. So you can choose the layout, including the breakpoints that you want to plan for. So right now it's defaulting to mobile and tablet, and the layout is going to determine how wide this content sits on your page. I'm going to leave it as is, and let's go back. We also have lightbox settings. So if you use an element that includes lightbox, you can set it from here. And then we won't touch the custom CSS and the additional settings. I believe it just opens to a new page back here on your WordPress website, which we won't get to here. But anyway, so now that we have our site settings set up, let's go ahead and exit out of here. And before I leave this page, I do want to just leave this as an existing page. So I'm just going to leave this as my style guide page. If I ever need to make changes to my style or my site settings, I can always come back here and use it as a reference. So I'm going to go ahead and leave that here and publish it. And we can take a look at it and just see that, okay, this is how all my elements are going to look just by default.